In this series of videos, we are going to learn how to use AutoCAD for 2D designing. As you can see, I have already opened the application. Every time you launch AutoCAD, this is what the interface is going to look like. Currently, I'm using the 2023 version of AutoCAD. However, this interface is slightly different in the previous versions. Although there are no major differences and there are exactly the same options, the appearance is a little different. Nevertheless, that won't pose a problem for you as long as you learn how to use AutoCAD in either version. So let's get started. On the left side, we can see the version of AutoCAD we are currently using, and right below, we can choose to either open an existing file or to create a new one. To open an existing file, all I have to do is click on the Open button in order for the Select File window to appear. From there, I can browse to the folders of my computer, find the file I wish to open, select it, and click Open on the right side at the bottom of the window. This time, I will just click Cancel since I don't plan on opening a file. Notice that on the right side, Recent Files appear. Those are files that were recently created, opened, or modified. To put it simply, they are the files you have lately reviewed, so AutoCAD gives you the opportunity to have quick access to them. You do not need to search the path in which those files are saved to open them. If you click on one of those files, it opens immediately. Now, I am going to create a new file by clicking the arrow next to the new button. In this way, a drop-down menu appears from which I can choose the template I want to use for my drawing. In this case, I will click on Browse Templates. The window Select Template, which contains a list with all the available templates, opens. It is highly recommended that among these templates you use either the ACAD or the ACAD ISO template. The main difference between them is that the ACAD ISO template is set up for the metric system, while ACAD is set up for the imperial system. So if you're going to draw in metric units, such as meters or millimeters, select this template. And if you're going to draw in inches, select ACAD. Once you select the template and click Open, a new file is created. But before I proceed to do that, I will click Cancel to show you something important. If you click directly on the new button instead of the arrow next to it, a new file will be automatically created using the template that was last selected. As you see, the file was automatically created without being asked to choose any template. In this way, I may not remember which template was last used, so it's highly recommended to select the right template for your project before you create a new file. At this point, I will close the new file. Click on the arrow next to the new button and select the ACAD ISO template. Then, I will click Open. The new file is created and we can see how the interface changes accordingly. In the upper left corner, there is an ACAD icon. By clicking this icon, a drop-down menu appears, which contains commands for creating new files, opening existing files, saving the current file, importing another file into the current file, exporting this file into a different format, and also printing the file. In addition, there is a list with the recent documents. I will click this icon again to close the drop-down menu. Notice that to the right of this icon there is the Quick Access toolbar, which contains some certain buttons like New, Open, Save, Save As, Open from Web and Mobile, Save to Web and Mobile, Plot, Undo, and Redo. We can modify this toolbar by adding or removing buttons according to our preferences. To add or remove buttons, I will click on the arrow next to the Redo button. I can check the buttons I wish to add and uncheck those I do not need to appear in the toolbar. In this example, I will check the option Workspace. Automatically, it is added to the toolbar. In the same way, I can continue adding buttons as I see fit. Next to this toolbar is the title bar, in which, along with the name of the application and the version we are using, the title of the open document appears. To the right of the title bar, there's a searching field. You can enter any keyword or phrase to search for information about a certain term or command with Autodesk Help. And trust me, this might prove very useful no matter how good your AutoCAD knowledge is. For example, let's say I need to find a specific command to remove duplicate lines and arcs. I will type the phrase delete duplicate lines on the search field and then I will press enter. The Autodesk AutoCAD Help window opens and as you can see, the results that appear are relative with the phrase I wrote. All I need is to find the one that answers my question. In the same way, if we don't remember how a certain tool works, we can type the name of the tool and find the result that corresponds to our need. But now, it's time to close this window and continue with the rest features of AutoCAD's interface. Below the Quick Access toolbar and the title bar is the menu bar. If the menu bar is not visible, as it happens in my case, all I need to do is click on the arrow in the Quick Access toolbar and select Show Menu Bar. Notice that the menu bar appeared. I can hide it again easily if I want to, just by clicking on the arrow in the Quick Access toolbar again and selecting Hide Menu Bar. I won't hide the menu again, since we usually want it to be visible, because there we can find all the tools and commands we need while we are working on a project. Below the now visible menu bar is the ribbon. The ribbon has replaced the toolbars that appeared circumferentially of the drawing area in much older versions of AutoCAD. There, just like in the menu bar, we can find all the tools we need. The main difference is that in ribbon, those tools are represented by icons that make them easy to distinguish. As you can see, those tools are separated in different tabs according to their function. For example, the Home tab has the tools we need to create a 2D drawing. Similarly, in the Annotate tab we can find tools relative to annotation, such as dimensions, explanatory texts, and many more. Now I will return to Home tab. As you may have already noticed, each tab is separated in several panels, each containing a group of tools falling into the same category. For instance, the Draw panel contains tools which are fundamentally used for drawing, Modify panel contains tools for modifying the parts of the drawing, and so on. The Drawing section is the dark area below the ribbon. Every open file appears as a tab at the top of the drawing area, and every one of those tabs shows the name of the open file. On the other hand, at the bottom of the drawing area, there is another type of tabs. The first one is the Model tab, which is active right now, and it's where we usually draw. Layout tabs are basically printing layouts that can be adjusted to the units that are used in the model, to the paper and the orientation we are going to print the model into, and last but not least, to the scale we want to print it. As you can see, the layout's background is white, and our drawing, if there was one, would appear in black lines, unless we change that setting. Back to the Model tab, there is one more important feature, which is the command line. Here we can type the name of any command and press Enter or Spacebar from the keyboard to activate it. I would also like to mention the view cube, which can be seen in the right corner of the drawing area, and the navigation bar under the view cube. By clicking a certain side of this cube or one of its arrows, we can change the view of the object. To understand this better, I have opened a simple 3D object that was created in AutoCAD. Right now, we see the top view of the object. I will click on the lower right corner of the cube, and now we see an isometric view of the object. Then, I will click the right view so we can see the right side of the object. To restore the top view, I'm going to click the white arrow at the top of the cube and then the rotation arrow pointing to the left to correct the orientation. Now the view is restored as it was in the beginning. As for the navigation bar, like its name indicates, contains tools that have to do with the navigation inside the project and will be explained further in the following lessons. Lastly, if we check the right side of the bottom, we will see a few more icons. This side at the bottom is called status bar. Status bar contains some very useful and helpful tools. When those tools are active, they make the procedure of drawing easier and quicker. However, that doesn't mean that all those tools should be always active. We have to decide when and which of them we need active while working on certain parts of a project.